Though he no longer lived with his family in their apartment at 2261 Verbena Street, Nathaniel Cater often stayed here. The last time he came to Verbena Street was about 2 weeks ago to discuss plans for celebrating his 28th birthday.
It is at this point just an eerie coincidence that Nathaniel Cater's family lived just a few apartments from where LaTanya Wilson was taken. She is one of only two females on the Special Task Force list. Nathaniel Cater even joined in the search for LaTanya Wilson.
The 28th victim in the series of killings of young people in Atlanta has been identified as 27-year-old Nathaniel Cater.
Alonzo Cater is fighting the temptation to be overwhelmed by the events surrounding the death of his son. This afternoon, he was waiting for his daughter to arrive from South Carolina before beginning funeral arrangements. Alonzo Cater knows his son was not an angel. Nate drank too much, spent some time in jail sleeping it off. But still, his father can't imagine how he got killed.
Well, I couldn't say. It just shocked me. He'd be drinking, you know, and be out. Like I said, he'd be out drinking and all. So there's ain't no telling what I'd have.
Over the past 5 months, Nate Cater stayed here at the Falcon Hotel on Lucky Street. He was working most recently on a construction job behind Mary Mac's restaurant on Ponce de Leon and Myrtle. And he was last seen alive by this man, his roommate, John Henley, last Thursday night.
He was a good guy. You know, he didn't bother nobody. You know, he drank. You know, me and Nate would walk, get up in the morning, go to work, come back, you know, go to restaurants together and everything, you know. If it happened to him, it happened to me.
Nate Cater was not retarded, as some of the older victims were. He is the oldest victim by several years, and sometimes he drank too much. Investigators are hoping that somewhere in there is a key piece of information that will unlock not only the puzzle of Nathaniel Cater's murder, but also of the other 27 Atlanta murders. Mark Picard, Action News.